Welcome to this Audiomatica hands-on video. We are going to show how to measure crossover components with CLIO Pocket. Inductors, capacitors, and resistors can be measured with CLIO Pocket out of the box. The system is supplied with a RCA to alligator clips cable, which can be used to connect the component to be tested. Let's start our CLIO Pocket software. Here we are running a version 2.11. But the following instructions should be valid for any CLIO Pocket software version. The system has already been installed, calibrated, and fully operational on this computer. For more information on how to get to this point, please read carefully the CLIO Pocket guide available on our website, www.audiomatica.com. Let's start by measuring an inductor. The procedure will be similar for other components. A brief introduction on the measurement technique implemented in CLIO Pocket is useful to understand how it works, especially in comparison with other commonly used techniques. We review first the classical technique to measure inductance. This involves the use of a sinusoidal voltage generator, a shunt resistor, and a voltmeter with proper bandwidth. The generator output level is known or can be measured with the voltmeter. As an example, might be in 1 volt 1 kHz sinusoid. The sensing resistor value is known, and the DC resistance of the inductor might have been also measured. The voltage on the shunt resistor should be read with a voltmeter. The inductance value can be calculated using a formula which can be derived from the test circuit we created. However, this procedure hides some pitfalls. In particular, the sensitivity and the reading is optimal only when the modulus of the inductive reactance is of the same order of magnitude as the value of the shunt resistor. If this condition is not satisfied, the error in the inductance reading can easily exceed 10%. Furthermore, given that only the voltage modulus is read, non-negligible values of the inductor resistance lead to further increase the error. CLIO Pocket uses an improved measurement method which addresses these problems. Operations are greatly simplified, ensuring much more reliable and precise results. Let's begin with an actual measurement and see how simple it is to carry out. You should connect the inductor to the CLIO Pocket output using the provided RCA to alligator clips cable. The in-out loop button should be engaged. Click on the units label within the level meter and select the correct measurement units for the component under test. In this case, we will select inductance. Then press the arrow that starts all measurements. You should see the reading quickly converge to a stable value. Our inductor measures 0.448 millihenries. As simple as that. There are some things to notice. When resistance, capacitance, or inductance are selected from the unit's label, the meter title is shown as LCR meter. Inputs controls such as auto range, phase reversal, and microphone phantom are disabled. When starting the measurement, the generator output controls are also grayed out. In this operational mode, CLIO Pocket outputs a series of sinusoids with amplitude 1 volt and variable frequency, until it settles to a specific frequency which gives the most reliable reading. The output frequency is visible from the bottom right corner of the CLIO Pocket application window. Let's examine in more depth the CLIO Pocket technique. This is the simplified schematic of CLIO Pocket output stage, with its 150 ohms output resistor. Engaging the in-out loop sends the voltage at the device under test back to CLIO Pocket input. Instead of using a single sinusoid at 1 kHz, the generated tone frequency is swept in steps in order to maximize the sensitivity of the voltage measurement, which is influenced by the load impedance. Let's see what happens to the voltages when measuring a 0.22 millihenries inductor. We start with a 750 Hz frequency. Then the frequency is stepped until the complex voltage reading reaches its maximum sensitivity. Compared to the classical technique with a 1 kHz tone, in this practical case, the CLIO Pocket method with sweeping tone improves the reading accuracy by one order of magnitude. Another improvement in respect to the classical technique is the use of the FFT analysis to read the voltage instead of using the multimeter. This allows to calculate the complex impedance seen from the CLIO Pocket output. Complex data is used to finally calculate the inductive or capacitive reactance of the component. As an example, in case of an inductor, the component value is calculated using the imaginary part of the complex impedance. The use of complex data, as the inductance imaginary part in the above example, allows to calculate the inductive reactance with improved accuracy. CLIO Pocket LCR meter outperforms the classical method while retaining simple and quick operation. Let's go back to measuring components using the same procedure we saw for the inductor. Let's measure a capacitor. But first, a word of warning. The most critical factor influencing these tests are connections, as with all impedance measurements. If you use pin to alligator's cables, use great care in avoiding false contacts which may arise if terminals are oxidized or alligators lose their bite. Select capacitance as units on the level meter. Check that in-out loop button is down and start the measurement. Our capacitor measures 3.27 microfarads. Finally, let's measure a resistor. We select resistance as units and proceed as in the previous example. Our resistor measures 101 ohms. When building a crossover or any other frequency selective device, the selection of components within a given tolerance range could guarantee the correct performance of the device. Suppose we are trying to select a 3.3 microfarads capacitor from a set of components with a 1% tolerance. We can select the relative reading of the capacitance by choosing the capacitance percentage option. In this mode, the multimeter shows the deviation from a reference value. The reference value can be set directly from the multimeter by clicking on the current reading, or the value can be set from the CLIO Pocket options under the meter tab. Let's set 3.3 microfarads as a reference value using this latter option. We can now easily sort capacitors by connecting them to the alligator clips while the measurement is running and checking the percentage deviation from the reference value. We now proceed as in the previous example and check the percentage deviation of each component. That's it. Thank you for watching this Audiomatica instructional video.